I am Subrata Ray at Corporate Ratings at ICRA. Today I'll be talking about our outlook for the tractor industry, the recent performance and the expected outlook. In the next 15 minutes, I'll take you through our outlook of the tractor industry. Let us start with the lockdown impact, because this was something which had an impact across all segments in recent periods. I'll start with a slide which shows how significant has been the impact of lockdown across sectors, how several other industry sectors have performed during July and August. This will help set the context about how well the rural segment or the tractor industry has done in contrast to many other sectors during this period. We are at slide 3 now. This slide focuses on the status of various segments of the economy as in July, August. While the virtual shutdown during April and May affected nearly all businesses, many segments which are marked in yellow came back to 70 to 90% of pre-COVID levels by the month of July, August. This happened as lockdown-related restrictions were gradually eased and across industries. There are, of course, few segments like airlines, hotels, restaurants, where recovery is naturally delayed. But in contrast, if you look at the two sectors which are marked in green bars, pharma is back to 100% of pre-COVID levels, while tractor during July and August has actually significantly exceeded the pre-COVID levels. Now, how has the tractor industry has managed to achieve this? Moving to the next slide, slide 4. Production was halted across the supply chain during lockdown. Most OEMs were also affected. Manufacturing operations, however, have ramped up in a healthy manner post-relaxation in lockdowns. High localization levels, which is about 90 to 95%. So the industry did not face any supply chain issues due to import bottlenecks. This also helped the tractor industry recover faster as compared to some of the other automotive segments. However, even in this industry, there were instances when presence of critical supplier in containment zone created some challenge given the localized lockdowns. Government not for harvesting operations enabled a timely harvest, even as non-availability of migrant labor disrupted harvesting activities to an extent. Overall, Rabi harvest remained healthy. Supply chain issues, access to mandis to some extent existed. Also for some time, crop realizations remained under pressure. Haulage demand remained weak during the period, with infrastructure activity remaining curtailed. This has, however, improved over the past 2 months. Now, I'll move on to discuss the domestic industry trend. The lockdown measures undertaken in view of the COVID-19 pandemic hampered tractor industry volume significantly in March and April 2020. However, aided by healthy Rabi cash flows across regions and progress of monsoon in line with forecasts, there has been a sequential improvement in tractor sales ever since. In August 2020, the industry is estimated to have recorded 72% year-on-year growth in wholesale volume and 27% growth in retail volume. OEMs have been ramping up production levels to ramp up inventory levels ahead of festive season and are gearing up for healthy sales for the rest of the year. Now to take up the monsoon update. In the past, domestic tractor volume growth had largely tracked the southwest monsoon in most of the years. This year, IMD's second stage forecast estimates monsoon precipitation at 102% of long period average. Temporal and spatial distribution of precipitation remains critical for the industry. Monsoon arrival this year was timely and aided early sowing. Monsoon progress has also remained healthy. The map indicates most part of the country has received adequate rainfall. Monsoon precipitation across most key tractor markets have been healthy. Reservoir levels remain healthy across all regions, which is a significant positive for the industry. Moving to agricultural production update, even as fear of adverse impact of untimely precipitation on kharif yields persisted, there was no major downward revision in crop estimates. Third advance estimates indicated an improvement in production levels across most crops. As can be seen in the exhibit, surplus has been healthy. The graph in the bottom is about MSP hikes. After healthy MSP hikes in financial year 2019, MSP price indicate increases, however, have been relatively modest over the past 2 years. Moving to the next slide, in general, kharif sowing has progressed very well and has been better than last year. Pre-monsoon kharif sowing commenced at a healthy pace with farming activities allowed during the lockdown. Ample rain during cyclone Nisargra coupled with healthy monsoon precipitation till date aided timely sowing. Kharif sowing acreage represents a healthy improvement over previous year, and this has exceeded normal levels for most crop categories. Now, if you look at the other critical aspect for the industry, which is the financing environment, Delinquency levels, which is 90 DPD levels as per channel check, has remained at moderate levels, supported by healthy farm cash flows. If you look at the delinquency trends in the left side exhibit, delinquencies have been steady and we don't see any deterioration happening. This is a very healthy sign in the current economic environment. Even as financiers have become more prudent in lending, financing availability continues to remain adequate. Overall, this is a significant positive for the industry. Now, I look at the other significant aspect, which is the changes in emission norms. If you look at the overall emission norms, we are transitioning to Bharat TREM IV norms, possibly by next year, October 2021. This was earlier scheduled for October 2020, but now has been deferred by 1 year. The next transition to Bharat V will happen by April 2024. So we have 3 years after transition to TREM IV. The key technological changes required are common rail fuel injection, involving distribution of fuel to injectors from a high pressure accumulator fed by a high pressure electronically controlled fuel pump. This allows control over injection timing and injection rate, thereby controlling air pollutant emissions. Exhaust gas recirculation. EGR systems recirculate a portion of the exhaust into the engine cylinder, aiding in lowering peak combustion temperature and NOx formation. Share of recirculated exhaust gas tailored to engine calibration. There are high pressure and low pressure variants dependent on whether exhaust gases are fed in before turbocharger or after the turbocharger. Diesel oxidation catalysts. DOC oxidizes air pollutants, hydrocarbons, carbon monoxide, and the soluble organic fraction of particulate matter. Efficiency of DOC higher in heavy duty diesel engines on account of presence of excess oxygen in exhaust. Now we move to the next slide. The new emission norm is applicable only for 50 HP plus tractors. There could be some portfolio reject by OEMs to allow for customers to opt for lower HP tractors. Overall cost increases for this change is about 10 to 12%. Looking at the current economic situation and current conditions, it will be very difficult to pass on the cost increase. So we believe some of the OEMs would try to reject their portfolio around 50 HP products. At the same time, the total size of the industry at this high HP category is only about 13% of volume. To that extent, the overall impact on the industry is likely to be minimal. Now we look at outlook. To summarize the industry growth drivers, agri cash flows, healthy rabi yield, farm cash flows, even as realizations were impacted for certain crops, haulage demand, current weak infrastructure activity curtailed haulage demand for tractors, government support, GOI's Government of India's agricultural and rural spend has been seen a significant surge of more than 100%, almost 125% surge in quarter 1, 21, partly led by front loading of some of the budgeted expenditure. We need to remember the extra spend which happened in the current year is on the back of 30% increase in rural and agri spending last financial year. Obviously, for the rest of the year, the momentum of rural spend in quarter 1 would not sustain, and one needs to wait and see how much enhancement is there on the budgetary allocation for this. Beyond cash transfers, policy support like supporting and promoting rural entrepreneurship linked to local livelihood ecosystem, digital infra approach, and facilitating agri and allied activities could have a much longer term multiplier effect on rural sector. Financing environment, the delinquency trends continue to remain at moderate levels. Monsoon precipitation has been very healthy. Evolution of emission norms is going to impact only about 13% of the total industry by volume, and the implementation is now delayed by 1 year. So the likely implementation date is only now October 2021. OEM production could remain impacted by localized lockdowns. Supplier based mapping, however, remains an issue because some of the suppliers located in containment zones could result in some extent of disruption for the industry. Moving to the final slides, ICRA had earlier forecast 2 to 4% growth in the domestic tractor volume in financial year 2021, led by uncertainty regarding the impact of pandemic on the farming community. Currently, we have revised the growth estimate to 7 to 9%, even as uncertainty continues to exist in relation to spread of the pandemic. Farm sentiments are expected to remain healthy. However, there are some downside risks to these estimates, emanating from spells for unfavorable rainfall or floods leading to crop damage or supply chain disruption, if any. Over the next couple of years, in the longer term, we peg our growth estimates as 6 to 7%. With this, I conclude my presentation. Thank you.